Good morning, everyone. Jai Shri Mataji. A very, very hearty welcome to this morning's meditation. Let us begin today's meditation by collectively bowing down and then raising our kundalini and putting ourselves into a bandhan. Let us place both of our hands on the Mother Earth. And let us take a few minutes to just establish our connection with the Mother Earth. This is always a good opportunity to bring ourselves into balance and to let go of all the heat and the negativity as we pray to the Mother Earth to absorb all that is unnecessary within us. As we keep our hands on the Mother Earth, let us bring our attention on the Muladhara Chakra, which is the first energy center, and we will now listen to Ganesh Atharvashesh.
Sarvam Jagadidam Tvattu sarvam jagadidam tvattastishtati sarvam jagadidam vairyaveshyati sarvam jagadidam vairyaveshyati tvam bhuyaho naro niro namah tvam chatvari vakpadani Vam Gunatrayati Taha Vam Devatrayati Taha Vam Kalatrayati Taha Vam Mulaadharasthito Silityam Vam Shakti Trayatma Taha Vam Yogino Dhyayanti Nityam Vam Brahma Tvam Vishvostvam Rudrasvam Indrasvam Agnistvam Vayostvam Suryastvam Chandramastvam Brahma Gurbhuvasvarum Vanadim Purvamucharya Varnadim Tadanam Anuswaraha Parataraha Ardhen Dhrasitam Tarena Viddham Etattava Manusvarupam Vakaraha Purvarupam Aparo Madhyamarupam Anuswara Shantyarupam Bindurutararupam Madhasandhanam Samhita Sandhihi Saisha Ganesha Vidya Ganaparishihi Nishrut Gayatri Chandaha Ganapate Devata Om Gam Ganapataye Ekadantaya Vidmahe Vakratundaya Dhimahe Tanno Danti Prachodayat Ekadantam Chaturhastam Pashamam Kushadharinam Tadam Chavardam Hastair Vibhranam Mushapatrajam Raktam Lambodaram Shurpakarnakam Raktavasasam Raktabandham Liptaham Raktapushpai Supuchitam Bhaktanukampriyam Devam Chakatkaranam Achyutam Avirbhutam Chasrishtyagav Prakruti Purushatparam Evam Dhyayati Yonityam Sayogi Yoginam Varaha Namo Vratapataye Pataye Namaste Astu Lambo Dhyayishka Vantaya Vidhanashine Shivasutaya Shri Vardhamurtaye Namo Namaha Saksha Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha
let us keep our complete attention on our Muladhara Chakra. And here we can pray to Sri Ganesha to give us auspiciousness and innocence. Let us also ask for purity of thoughts, pure desires, and a lot of love and peace in our heart, compassion in our heart. And forgiveness in our spirit. As we approach Christmas, this is a very, very good time to work and keep working on our Ragya Chakra, to get rid of all the unresolved issues in our life, and to forgive everyone. This is also a good time to forgive ourselves for anything wrong we may have done, knowingly or unknowingly. So let us bring our complete attention on our forehead, which is the Ajna Chakra. And let us say, I forgive everyone. I forgive everyone, and I forgive myself. So let us just keep our attention on our forehead, and as we work on this energy center, we will now listen to 108 names of Sri Jesus Christ. So all we have to do is just listen from our Sahasrara and keep our attention on the top of our head or on the forehead.
Om Shri Ajna Chakra Swamine Namo Namaha. Om Shri Suryaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Kshama Pradayakaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Kshama Swarupaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Shamadama Vairagya Titiksha Pradayakaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Omkaraya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Chaitanyaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Adi Purushaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Sahasra Shirshaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Sahasrakshaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Vishnave Namo Namaha. Om Shri Vishnu Sutaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Mahavishnave Namo Namaha. Om Shri Anantakoti Brahmanda Dharakaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Hiranyagarbhaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Purvaghoshitaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Brahma Vishnu Rudra Sevitaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Pavitra Pradayakaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Gopalaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Gosevitaya Namo Namaha. Om Shri Krishna कृष्णसुताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री राधानंदनाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री पापनाशकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री पापविमोचकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री प्रकाशाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आकाशाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री अग्नये नमो नमः। ॐ श्री महाकारुण्यरूपिणे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री तपस्विने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री हंक्षं बीजाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आत्मने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री परमात्मने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री अमृताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आत्मतत्वजाताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री शांताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री निर्विचाराय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आदि आज्ञाचक्रस्थाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री कल्कये नमो नमः। ॐ श्री एकादश रुद्रसेविताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री उत्क्रांति तत्वाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री उत्क्रांति आधाराय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री सर्वोच्चाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री महत्मनसे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री महत् अहंकाराय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री तुरीयास्थिति प्रदायकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री तुरीयावासिने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री द्वाराय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री कार्तिकेयाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री महागणेशाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री अबोधितास्वरूपाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री अबोधिताप्रदायकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री शुद्धाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री मांगल्यप्रदायकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री औदार्याय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री महालक्ष्मी नेत्र तेजसे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री परिपूर्ण सहज योगिने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आदि सहज योगिने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री श्रेष्ठ सहज योगिने नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देवी प्रियकर्त्रे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री शाश्वताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री स्थाणवे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री सच्चिदानंद घनाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री स्वैराचार नाशकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री धर्ममार्तण्डनाशकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री निरीक्षाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री धनदाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री शुद्धश्वेताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आदिबालकाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री आदिब्रह्मचारिणे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री पुरातनाय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री अल्फाय ओमेगाय च नमो नमः। ॐ श्री समस्त साक्षिणे नमो नमः। ॐ श्री ईशपुत्राय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री मोहवर्जिताय नमो नमः। ॐ श्री ममताहताय namo namaha. Om Shri Vivekaya namo namaha. Om Shri Aghoranashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Jnanarupaya namo namaha. Om Shri Sadbuddhidayakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Sudnyaya namo namaha. Om Shri Purnanamraya namo namaha. Om Shri Bhautikatanashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Ahankaranashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Pratiahankarashoshakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Ashuddhichhanashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Hridmandirasthaya namo namaha. Om Shri Agurunashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Asatya Khandanaya namo namaha. Om Shri Vamshabhedanashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Krodhanashakaya namo namaha. Om Shri Adishakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Priyaputraya namo namaha. Om Shri Adishakti Architaya namo namaha. Om Shri Pratishthana Kshetra Nivasakritaya namo namaha. Om Shri Kabela Vasine namo namaha. Om Shri Sahasrara Dwara Vasine namo namaha. Om Shri Nishkalankaya namo namaha. Om Shri Nityaya namo namaha. Om Shri Nirakaraya namo namaha. Om Shri Nirvikalpaya namo namaha. Om Shri Lokatitaya namo namaha. Om Shri Gunatitaya namo namaha. Om Shri Mahayogine namo namaha. Om Shri Nityamuktaya namo namaha. Om Shri Avyaktamurtaye namo namaha. Om Shri Yogeshwaraya namo namaha. Om Shri Yogadhamne namo namaha. Om Shri Yogaswarupaya namo namaha. Om Shri Yeshu Christaya namo namaha. Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai namo namaha.
Let us keep our attention on the top of our head. The 108 names that we just heard not only have the vibrations, but they also have the qualities, 108 qualities of Sri Jesus Christ. And even though we might not understand all the Sanskrit names, our spirit has the capacity and the capability to absorb. And also understand these qualities. Let us enjoy a couple of minutes of silence, and then we will listen to a short talk by Shri Mataji given on Christmas Puja.
I'm assured by his resurrection how he ascended into the realm of spirit, which he was, because he was Pranava, he was Brahma, he was Mahavishnu, as I have told you about his birth. In a body, like a human being, he wanted to show another thing, that spirit has nothing to do with money, has nothing to do with power. It is all powerful, all pervading. What is born in a stable. Not in a palace or to a king, but he was born to a very ordinary person, a carpenter. In Hindi language, Bacha, then nothing is greater than you, isn't it? It means simply that. Nothing is higher than you, neither anything can decorate you, because whatever you are at the highest. All the worldly things so-called are just like dry grass, Trinavat. So he was kept in the dried grass. So many it makes very unhappy, and they feel very sorry that Christ, the one who came to save us, was kept under such conditions, and why not God provided him with something better? But to such people it does not matter. Whether you are lying in the dried grass, or in the stable, or in the palaces, everything is just the same, for it does not touch them. They are so detached, and they are completely in joy. They are the masters of themselves. Nothing can master them. No matter can master them, no comfort can master them. They are masters of complete comforts within themselves. They have achieved all the comforts within themselves. They are satisfied people. That's why they are kings. They are called as kings, not those kings who run after things, but those kings who seek comforts in life. I mean, if you have comforts, well and good. If you don't have, well and good. Makes no difference. So many people, especially in Latin America when I went there, they said, but we can't understand why Christ was born as a poor man. This is again the human concept about God is. See, he wants to command God. Be born in a king's palace. He cannot order him about. accepts about God, that why should he be a poor man? Why should he be helpless? He never showed his helplessness. He was much more dynamic than all your kings and all your politicians put together. He was not afraid of anyone. Whatever he had to say, he said it. He was not afraid of crucifixion or any such punishment so-called. It's only the human beings, you see, who have these false ideas about life. And that's why they want to put these ideas onto God also and try to make him follow their own concepts. God is not your concept. He is not a concept at all. To also say that concept is, after all, is a concept, is also a concept. This I found out very recently. This is another myth people carry. Those who say that, oh, concept is a concept, all right. Mataji says, all right, so what? But even this is a concept. Because concept is thought. You have to rise beyond thought, at a higher level, into thoughtless awareness, where you are not in thought, but you are in the center of the thought, in the sense that one thought rises and falls, and there's a place in between, another thought rises and falls. You are in the center of these thoughts. The Vilambas, we call it, the time where you pause. Then you will understand Christ. He was here, partly, of course, to save us. Because he had many aspects, I should say. Not only to save human beings, he came on this earth. There were many more aspects. You see, also human beings have a demand, you see, that they must be saved. Why? One should, from God's angle, if you see, why should they be saved, all of them? What have they done for God? How can we demand God that you must save us? Can you? You cannot ask for that. So he did come to create the passage between, as you see here, Vishuddhi and the Sanstara, this Agya. In the primordial being, the Virat, he was born there to open that door. In evolution, every incarnation has come on this earth to open a particular door within us and to create that opening or that enlightenment in our awareness. So Christ came precisely for opening this small little door, which is constructed by our ego and superego. Ego and superego are the two byproducts of our thought process. One, the thoughts that are of the past, and the other, thoughts of the future. He came to make that gap, to cross that gap, and that's how he has sacrificed himself, his body, for you it is a very big thing of remorse and repentance. But for such people, it is not. It's a play. They have to play a certain role. That's why I do not understand, why do you show him to be such a lanky-panky, miserable creature? He was never miserable. Such people sensible as you are. This is another concept of man, that she should be lanky, panky, tally, skinny, starved, bones coming out, count them one by one. Horrible idea. From his childhood to his death, he was joy person. He was happiness. He was joy. To make you all happy, to give you the light of happiness, by enlightening your source of joy, that is your spirit in your heart, that he came on this earth, not only to save you, first to give you happiness, to give you joy. Because human beings in their ignorance and in this tomfoolery are unnecessarily beating themselves and destroying themselves. When nobody asked you to go to pubs, to get into trouble. Nobody has asked you to go to races and become bankrupt. Nobody has asked you to go to horrible gurus and get into troubles. But you seek your destruction wantonly. Then he comes there, like a morning flower, to make you happy. First, to make you happy. To give you joy. You see, any child, you see, any child, at least I know myself, I don't know about the funny people here. I mean, for them flowers also look like thorns. I mean, I don't know how they manage that stuff. But you see a child anywhere, any child, such a joy-giving thing it is. And this is the child of the divine that comes on this earth as a child. It's the most joy-giving thing. And that's why Christmas for all of us, for the whole universe, should be a festival of great joy. For he brought light for us by which you could see that there is someone called as God, there is someone who is going to remove this ignorance. This was the first beginning. So, for us, it is necessary to be first joyous and be happy and relaxed. And not to take anything that seriously as we take. Because divine life doesn't make you serious, because it's all a play. It's a maya. I've seen in all the rituals that people follow, in all the so-called religious people, they are too serious to be religious. A religious person is bubbling with laughter. He doesn't know how to hide his joy. And he doesn't know how to control his laughter when he sees people who are unnecessarily serious. I mean, nobody's dead. The way the people sit is sometimes you just don't know what to do with yourself. You just can't control. So there's nothing in this world for a person like Christ to feel sad about. And if you really believe in him, then please, first of all, give up your this silly sadness. And sulking and sitting down and becoming morose, not talking to anyone, silent bores all over. That is not the way to look at Christ. See how he went and talked to multitudes. How he opened his hands to all the people around and how he tried to give them happiness.
Mm-hmm. So, as Shri Mataji has said, let us try to make this festival of Christmas a festival of joy. And the only way we can keep the joy bubbling in our heart is by first of all opening our agya, letting go of all the conditionings, letting go of all the mental thought processes that we have going all the time. And that is the only way we can forgive and truly be in joy. So let us make this time of the year an opportunity to really open our minds to the infinite. I'll play some music and let's meditate for a few more minutes and then we will finish the meditation. Let us end our meditation by raising our kundalini and putting ourselves into a bandhan and giving a namaskara to Shri Mataji. A big thank you to everyone for joining us this morning, and for all those who have joined us new today, everyone who's new to this group, we have morning meditations at 5 a.m. Brisbane time or 6 a.m. Sydney time on this group, and the evening meditations happen on the Journey Within group. The meditations, once they happen, they are uploaded here for you to be able to watch at any time, and we have heaps and heaps of meditations which are already uploaded, so please feel free to browse through the group. This particular group is Sahaja Yoga QLD, and thank you so much for joining us, and we will see you again tomorrow morning same time, which is 6 a.m. Sydney time or 5 a.m. Brisbane time. So wherever you are watching from, a very good morning to you, or a good day to you, and we will see you again tomorrow. And I'll leave the music on for some more time so you can continue meditating, and thank you so much. Jai Shri Mataji. See you again later in the evening. Thank you.